Cool. So, we are going to be doing a design for a band called EXNATIONS. They're a new band out of New York. And they hit me up for merch design, and they want something pretty bold. They gave me a little brief to follow, so I'm gonna just start putting stuff together based off their brief and talk through it a little bit as I'm going. So, we're gonna start by drawing out a box and like maybe make it not the same size as the artboard, but like roughly the same sort of ratio, because our artboard essentially represents the area of our shirt. So let's just keep that in mind. So I'm starting with a box because that's one thing they know they want, is to have a box, kind of. Based off examples they gave me, this is one of the things that they want to make sure we keep. So let's see here. I think the other thing I'm gonna do is we're gonna have some sort of pattern going on. And I think that it'll be cool to have a pattern within a side of a pattern, possibly. So we're gonna play around with that. Here we go. So we can build the basics of it pretty much all with our shape tools and then just kind of tweaking them around. We're not going to need to really do any custom drawings for this. It can all be done in Illustrator. And I'm gonna go and use the align. I'm gonna use a lot of these align tools up here really to help me with this next part I'm doing. And I think the other big thing to note with this is that it's not gonna look great until we're just about done. Then that's kind of when it's gonna start looking good. Sorry about that. So yeah, like it's obviously not looking great right now, but that's okay because we're gonna clean it up and make it look great. So again, using my align tools up here to start to get something a little better looking together. So, as you can see, like it's something starting to come in together. Like, you know, maybe still not exactly what we want, but it's definitely something's kind of some sort of cool little things coming out of this right now, and that's where we want to be at. We definitely want to give them something cool in this area within the box. And so the thing too to keep in mind is you want to keep it, when I drag it over here, you'll see there's that white box, and you don't want that essentially because that's going to get printed on a shirt. But for my designing purposes, it's fine to have it because it's helping me visualize everything. But at the end, we're going to go back and we're going to take it out, and it won't be there. And adding these white bars off to the side is doing the same thing as adding the white in the center. It's just helping me visualize what's gonna be going on without actually having to worry about kind of cutting all of this out yet, in case I want to go back and tweak it. So it's almost like a placeholder until we actually go in and tweak it. So as I'm getting a little bit further along here, I'm liking this a lot, but it looks possibly a little bit crowded over here. And I think, let's try this. And let's just see if this maybe gives us a little bit more space. So that's a little bit more space, but it's still crowded, and I think the quick fix for that is going to be just to keep using these same aligning tools we're using, but drag the top one down and then align it. And now, if we go in and align it again like that, and go ahead and flip it, we should end up with something a little bit nicer looking. Okay, a little bit nicer looking, but I do kind of want a shape in there to fill up that space. So we're gonna have to do that as well. And I think the easiest way to get that sort of shape is just gonna be to come over here. And honestly, let's just use this cool little shape builder tool over here. Let's build. So I just built a shape in the center right there, which is grouped, but if I delete all this stuff, then now we have this diamond shape, and this should fit in really nicely right in there. And we're just gonna have to play around with it to get the sizing to be about right, but as I say that, it does look pretty nice right there, I'd say. And let's make this box a little bit bigger, because I like that. Okay, so we're at a pretty good place right now. This design's coming along pretty well. Okay. That's cool. And so the thing I'm going for is that the pattern's gonna kind of bleed out of the edges of this box by a little bit. So that's kind of what I'm doing with these boxes off to the sides, just giving a little bit of bleed. And I'm also going to give it a little bit of blue. I'm gonna have kind of a space right in here. I'm gonna have to zoom in to get that, but I'm gonna have essentially this space in here, and then it'll look like the pattern kind of pops out of that space a little bit. And again, there's easier ways to get this. I'm just using this almost as a placeholder. But that's giving us something pretty. Yeah, so there we go. So it's almost like it kind of pokes out a little bit below. We might tweak it around a little bit, but for now, let's just leave it right around there-ish. Maybe even a little bit smaller. I'm not sure. We'll play around with it. 'Cause I do. It's a tough one. Let's try and pull this stroke down a bit. Ooh, see? Okay, I like that. I'm liking it with the stroke down a little bit. Okay. Yeah, that's opening it up a lot, and I think that'll make it a lot better. Okay, perfect. I think that definitely added to it a little bit. So now, as I'm looking at it, the one thing that I'm seeing is that these little four corners, they're barely poking out, and I don't like that, so I'm gonna make it slightly bigger. And then let's see. Yeah, see, I think that's a little bit better looking. Again, I'm just gonna make sure these are aligned. There we go. Perfect. So we have a pretty cool looking basis to work off of right here. And that took us like what? Like 5 to 10 minutes. So we're in pretty good shape right here. And I think we still have a lot of work to do, but we're in good shape. Okay. So let's bring this up here and get the similar looking thing at the top. But what I'm gonna wanna do up here, I think, is put the band name up here, and I'm either going to possibly, I might write EXNATIONS across the top and kind of put a chip out of the word EXNATIONS. We can try that out really quickly. So let's do that and see how that looks. Okay. So look at, okay, so now we're gonna pick a font. And I'm gonna look for something bold. This could be cool. That's a cool one. Let's see what this one looks like. But it might not be, it's a little too, possibly too stylized. Here's the two things I don't like about this font. It's a little too stylized for this pattern, and it's a little too tall. Because it's a tall design as it is. So I'd like to get something. Let's try this. Yeah, okay. I'm liking that. And I think we should adjust the kerning on it a little bit. Let's drop it down to -75 to see. Okay, that's pretty nice looking. Let's go to optical, which will squeeze it in a little bit better. There. Okay, I like that. It almost gives us a little ligature with the TI. Okay, so I think this font's a little better. Not as tall. Okay, so that's pretty good looking. So my idea was maybe to take that chip out right there, but now as I look at it, I think rather than take that chip out of the word EXNATIONS, because the word would probably want to sit right around there, that'd be taking a pretty drastic chip out of the word just to fit that little caret in. So instead, let's try and put that little caret possibly on top of the word. And the other thing too is that let's maybe make this pattern even thinner to match the width of the font. Let's just try that out. So let's say we go about that thin. And the other thing too is now if we're going thinner, we might want to throw another stripe in there. Because if we're opening up the pattern too much, it might look better if we just were able to throw that. Yeah, see, now, like I was saying, I think it might honestly be better to throw in that extra little stripe on each side just to close it up a little bit more. Let's see. I'm just going to do this little test where I'm going to look at it from far away and then close up just to kind of see, because people are going to be looking at the shirt from far away and close up, and I want to see. Let's try adding one more little nut carrot thing in here. Again, using the align tools to space it out. We'll do the same thing with the other side. Space them out equally with the align tools. Boom. Okay. Two things I like about this. Let's move them a little more up like this. And move this one a little more down like that. Okay. And then I'm going to also make sure that it's centered vertically. Make sure everything's centered vertically. Okay, so that's all centered vertically right there. Now we're gonna have to adjust this diamond again because that's about good right there. Okay, so now I think our pattern's a little bit better looking. We kind of thinned it out and opened it up and then kind of brought it back together again. Okay, and now if we were to take a little caret out of this font, it maybe wouldn't be as bad. Let's try it. Let's just take, here's going to be a cheap little, way to do that. So I'm just going to make this one caret right here white and just place it right over the text, and it'll give us a little bit of a feel for it. So let's send it, let's make it white and then send it to the back, and then make our text, don't do anything with our text and send a text to the back. Boom, there's a little caret out of it. Right off the bat, I just don't love it. So let's go with the idea of having a little caret on top, because this one, we tried it, just didn't come out great. Okay, so here's gonna be our quick way to put this little caret on the top, I think. Will be, let's just get that lined up right there. Now let's, I'm gonna save a copy of this, and by save a copy I mean just duplicate a copy off to the side right there. That way if I mess up I have a copy sitting right there. But I think what's gonna be the best way to do this is gonna just be to expand it out. And when I expand it out, these aren't editable lines anymore. They're editable, they're just not strokes. Okay, now if I make this a compound path and I go ahead and do this pathfinder, we have this little caret to play with up there, which is perfect. So let's move this back in, and we might want to align it up again. It's bleeding a little. We have two options. We can kind of make the words line up with that right there, or we can make the words line up with the box. So we'll try both and see what works better. But check this out with this caret up here on top of the word. That's going to look real cool. So let's see here. Let's go ahead and okay, now that's with the font lined up off to the sides, and I don't like it as much. I'm definitely liking it a little bit smaller. So let's go in here, and I'm playing the same four songs again and again, so let's play something else here. Okay. Cool. See that? I think that's looking a lot better. Let's give the font a little more breathing room. Boom. Okay. Now this is getting pretty cool, and we're getting pretty close to being done, and I do like having that little chunk out at the top. Just gives it, it gives it that nice little balance with the one with that chunk out right there. Okay. So the big thing, the really big thing we have to do right now before we kind of take this into texturing and finalizing is we have nothing in the center right here. So I'm just kind of trying to think of a couple things. I'm trying to think, A, what would I put in the center, and B, kind of what makes sense in terms of like the band's vibe and in terms of the patterns we already have going, like visually what would make sense. Also, I just wanted to see, would it make sense to maybe have those little corners right there be cut off, because I kind of see a lot of white room in those corners. Something we'll figure out in a second. That'll be an easy thing to go back and do. Right now, let's worry about this. So one thing that comes to mind, and I don't know why, maybe something about the word nations, I don't know, is let's do a sort of solar system. Not a solar system per se, but something that'll look kind of like it. So let's give a couple planets, I think, is more what I was getting at. Okay. So there's nothing I'm going off of right now. I'm just gonna kind of add some circles vertically in different shapes, and then at the end hope that they kind of look solar system-ish. I think what might benefit this design is giving it two colors. That might help. But yeah, this kind of looks, maybe these need a little bit more space. Maybe if we sized all of these down and then spaced them out a little bit. Yeah, that was definitely what it needed. Just a little bit more breathing room. Okay, so again, not planets per se, but they kind of just give me that vibe. And I kind of like this. I like this. I'm not sure why. I just kind of like it. God, you know, sorry. I'm just going to go and look at this spacing. And so here's the two things going through my mind. The first thing is, should we add kind of sort of arched dotted lines so you kind of see like the paths they're taking through the solar system? That's one thing we could always do, but it might be a little too busy with this pattern in the back. And that's kind of what I'm leaning towards, is that it's going to be too busy. So there's two things I want to try. One, let's maybe just try a big old X through this planet for X nations, you know? So I'm just going to try that out, and we will see how that looks. Okay, so right here, I'm just making a quick little X. We'll make it white, and we can just stick it right over. That's our center right there. Okay. That's our big old X right there. For X nations. It's a little interesting. I think that's cool, actually. I think we'll stay with that. So I'm going to duplicate this artboard over, and now let's start playing with a couple different color options. Sorry, just these, I'm just again thinking, should I do, you know what, here, let's just do that really quick. This will be a real quick add. Is just adding these little corners, and I'm going to kind of use a very sloppy, not professional way to do it, but it's going to be quick. So, and that's what I'm looking for right now. And I'm just going to erase this, basically, is what I'm going to do. Just turn the music up a little bit because it was pretty low. I don't know if anyone could hear it before. Okay. So, like, I'm just going to erase the top, so it's just going to be kind of hidden behind that, and then, like, boom, there you go. That pretty much was a quick, kind of dirty way to get the clean result I wanted in the end. So, like, that doesn't look very pretty, but then, boom, you get that. Let's do it to the bottom as well. Literally the exact same thing. Let's just erase it right along here. Alright, and there we go. So, really quickly, while I'm thinking about it, do a quick center. It adjusted everything a little bit. That's what we wanted. I'm seeing just a weird little line in the T and I nations. So I'm just thinking maybe if we squeeze this, like negative 100, that's a little, see, I think that's a little bit better on our current. And it doesn't want to work with me. There we go. Okay, cool. Let's move that carrot up so we have a little better spacing. Okay, now I would like to recolor it. So I'm going to bring it over here. Okay. So I want to keep the majority of it black and white, but let's play around with some maybe reds and blues. Sorry, not a fan of that red, but I'm going to go over here with my hue saturation black slider, and let's get something not necessarily too dark, because we have the darkness of the black, but maybe something a little desaturated, and I think that's a nice looking red right there. Okay. So that's one colorway right there. Maybe, here, let's make this dog back to black. Maybe there you go. Maybe there's EXNATIONS, and then that's the EXNATION right there, you know? Who knows? Let's do four color options. And the other thing, too, is it's going to be very easy to do like a basically an inverse of what we already have. So like a black with a white design, and maybe a black with a white design with some blue could look cool. So why don't we try that? Why don't we try a black with a white design, and then a black with a white and blue? So I'm just going to draw the black in right here. Actually, you know what's going to be even easier? It's just going to be easiest to mock it up in Photoshop. That'll be where we'll play with the colors easiest. So I have two pretty close to finalized designs here. And I jumped the gun on coloring because we still have these blocks, which we don't want. Because when we pull it over into Photoshop, I mean, we could take the blocks out in Photoshop as well, but essentially this is what's going to get printed. So when we have the white there, it's going to print these white blocks, which we don't want. So it's actually going to be easiest for me if I go edit this outside of my white artboard, just so I can see what I'm doing. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take all of these carrot things, and I'm going to select them all. And I'm going to turn them into a compound path, which should make Illustrator treat them all like they're one path. Boom. Okay, there we go. So they should essentially be one path right now, which is perfect. So what I want to do is I'm going to get these two bars kind of lined up close to where I want them. So I'm thinking maybe right around there on either side. I'm going to group them and I'm going to center them with everything. And when I do that, now they're equally spaced away from that. So when I do the next thing, which is make them a compound path, and then use my pathfinder on the two compound paths, boom, look at that right there. Send that to the back, and then look at that. That's a nice looking clean cut down the side right there. Next thing is going to be this box right here. But actually, before we do the box, let's do this X, which will be easy. So let's just expand these out. And it's going to be the pathfinder again. We're going to combine them together into the X and then cut them out of that X. So now this X is like that. Okay. I just real quick thought I had while I'm looking at this. And this is the thing with merch designs is you gotta make them quick, but also I rarely would say I know exactly what my finalized design is gonna look like when I start. When I start, I have an idea in my head, and then I just kind of play around heavily with stuff as I'm going. And that's kind of where my final design comes from, is just playing with stuff to see what looks better. Okay, so what I was thinking is we might have a planet marked X, which would be our X nation. Let's just see really quickly if this is better, is like our X marked planet. Okay, so that's tough. We have that, we have this EXNATION, and then we have this one. Or third option that we have right here is, and this one maybe is our winner. This one's cool again. Ooh, actually maybe not. That one, it takes a lot of the black out. see that. There's not a, okay. See, that one's even hard to tell the circle. So that one's definitely not in the running. So it's kind of one of these two. So that one versus this one. I like that one. I don't know why. Something about it I like. Okay, so the thing is that this one is, that's still the white, and then now we're gonna have to do this X again, so we're gonna just expand it out and then cut it out of that circle. Alright, let's cut out of that circle, and then okay, so now here's the big thing, is getting this white. So we're gonna expand this. Okay, so here's the thing now, is we kind of have a box. We have the white box and the black box, essentially. And this white box is what we want to get rid of. Like, so. Let's make all of these a compound path again. So they'll all be a path. And then let's take this white inner box and let's cut it out. Oh, okay. See that? We missed these. We missed this little piece. This little diamond in here. We missed. So I need to expand that out. Okay. So now that that's expanded, and now that we, you know what? Yeah. Okay. So now that the diamond's expanded, we can combine that with our other compound path. So we have that, and now when we do it, there we go. Look at that. Last little thing is this carrot down here that we want to get, and let's just line that up right there, and let's do this last little knockout right there. Boom. Okay, so now we're in a better place to sample these colors. And so, really, I mean, I'll keep all of this just for in case I need to go back for whatever reason, but really, this is kind of our finished design right here, which is pretty cool. That's going to make a cool shirt, I think. And here's going to be our two main variations, which we'll quickly go into Photoshop and play on colors. So we're going to do 16.5 by 20.5.